So most of us don't save enough money. So I'm going to ask this question. Is this an right, is income minus expense equals saving same as income minus saving equals expense? Is it the same? Income minus expense equals saving. We get this right? But is it the same as income minus saving equals expense? Same or? Yes, no? Wow, the night crowd very quiet. Never mind. It warm you up a bit. Need to get you all to think. So is it the same? Not the same, right? But in maths, we all learn it's the same. If I draw here, hope you all can see. So income minus expenses equal savings. Agreed? Then, income minus savings equal expenses. Same or different?
Same.
According to maths, it's supposed to be the same. But in real world, it's very different. Now, income minus expenses is your income. You spend whatever you spend for balance, you call saving. Agreed? Then you repeat this process over time. This saving goes to the next month's overall account. Plus your income. You spend again for balance, you call it saving again. So given long period of time, you hope these savings grow. Agreed? But some months you spend more than usual. Your saving becomes little. Start again. But this formula is what most people do. But where this is different is that income minus savings equal expenses is a better formula. Despite it's the same, it's a better formula. So if today my income, I save what I want to save first, the rest all I spend. Next month, same thing then. The fun begins because I got income. After setting aside saving, your job, spend all. Don't leave anything balance. Which are more fun to do? I think it's all more fun, right? Spend until the last cent. But given time, what I keep accumulating is this thing called savings. And I will have more multiples than this if I use this method, which all of you think is the same. Numerics is the same. Outcome so different. And the problem is Singapore, we are the best nation for this thing called maths in the world, and we're ranked number one when it comes to maths. Agree not? Now I say one, a lot of websites say Singapore when it comes to maths, we are number one in the world. But when it comes to personal finance, I still think a lot of people don't know how to count. Because why? No one teach us the formula. If someone teach you the formula all the way throughout, they can be very good at personal finance. So what I'm teaching here today is basic financial, personal financial mathematics. A lot of people don't know one, all the same one. Life, not predictable. Formula, all the same. So, it's very important to pay ourselves first.